try. So what we are finding here, we call the slope. We also call it the rate of what?
Rate of change.
Change, good. The delta y, delta x. Might be change in y, but is the change in x? Here, let's just give ourselves a little bit of something to think about, to visualize what's going on here. Let's say that this x value represents time, and that this represents distance. Let's see if we can give ourselves a little more to put this in context. Distance walked, how far we walked.
So
this represents another time, and this represents another distance walked. What's that, Charlie?
So time is x.
Time is x.
Distance
walked.
Yeah,
is y, yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So what we're looking for is the slope. We're looking for the rate of change. We're looking for the delta y over delta x, change in y over change in x. So in this context, there's a person who 3 seconds ago was one meter, right, in distance. And 1 second ago, not 3 seconds ago, but 1 second ago, he was 5 meters, from some reference point. Okay. So we're gonna find the rate at which he walked. First, we need to figure out how far he walked. How far did he walk?
3 meters.
How far did he walk between this and this?
4.
4, right? 5 minus 1 is a distance, a total change in distance of 4. He walked 4 meters from this point to this point. Okay. How long did it take?
2 seconds.
It took 2 seconds. It was 3 seconds ago up to 1 second ago, right? Negative 3 minus negative 1 gives us that. Negative 3, sorry. Let's see.
And I go to the twice. So
what did I do? I did it backwards, right?
Yeah, you forgot to put y1, y2.
Should be negative 1 minus negative 3.
Why did you switch it around, though?
Why did I switch it around?
Yeah. I got 5 minus 1.
Well, 5 minus 1, if I do 5, right, that comes from this point.
Oh, yeah.
It's called point number 2. Mm-hmm. It's point number 1. So you go y's, well, this y, which we call y2. This is from the second point, minus y1. So this guy better be x2, otherwise we'll get negative 2 seconds, like I was about to.
Wait, shouldn't y1 go first?
It won't matter. If I choose this to be point 1 and this point 2, if I do y1, 1 minus 5, then down in the denominator we'll get negative 3 minus negative 1. I'll show you that in just a second. All
right.
How it won't matter.
Yeah.
Okay. So we walked 4 meters. And it took us 2 seconds. How fast were we walking?
Two meters per second.
2 meters per 1 second.
That's very fast.
2 meters per 1 second, 4 meters for 2 seconds, and so on.
2 meters,
6 feet. Roughly. It's like 6 feet per stride. It's like 6 feet per second. You think somebody runs 6 feet per second?
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that. Amazing. It's not walking. Fast walk, maybe. Maybe it should be jogged.
Probably get ready to.
Instead of walking. Okay. The thing that I'm trying to remind you of is that this is not only the slope of a line, like how slanty the line is, but it's the rate of change of the y versus x. Okay, so it's going 2 meters per second. The slope of the line is 2/1, right? If I was looking at the line, I would go up to the right one. Here we go. Line would look like, yes.
Could you graph it?
Could I graph it?
Yeah, like have negative 3, positive 1,
yep.
Negative 1, positive 5,
yep.
And then do the slope and see how many goes up by 2.
Okay.
All right.
I wouldn't recommend it,
mm-hmm.
But like, if you feel like you're familiar enough with y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, and you're like, yeah, this is just this other way, then I sure do it that way. If you're doing it to avoid this subtraction, okay, then don't do that. Don't right. avoid any learning. But let me just show you, so you said maybe should y1 come first. If it did, you get 1 minus 5, right? y1 minus y2. Let's do then x1, which is negative 3, minus x2. This is just looking at like what happened as we, if you like rewind the video of this person jogging, they would go back 4 meters, but they would also go negative 3 minus negative 1 is negative 2. They'd go back 2 seconds. Right? So this is a video of a person still 4 over 2 positive 4 over 2 negative divided by negative is positive. Right? Or
oh, so I mean, it doesn't
really
matter. If you saw those and you put them together, you could just go negative 3.
Minus negative 1.
Yeah, can you put negative 3 minus 1? I mean, yeah, negative 3 minus negative 1 on top.
No.
And the y on the bottom.
Y is the y for a reason. This is, so, the x is what you call your independent variable, right? Usually time. Mm-hmm. Time just goes along. And 1, 2, 3, 4, second after second after second. It just moves along and it doesn't really depend on anything else, it just goes. Okay? But depending on what time it is, this person will be a different distance. Right? The distance depends on the time. Where is this person? How far have they walked? It'll depend. It depends on when it is, what time it is. Right? Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So you got the dependent, that's time. Time just goes. You can't stop time, time doesn't depend on anything unless you're a quantum physicist. We won't get into that. It just goes, and then how far you go depends on when it is, how long it's been, how long you've been walking, jogging, running, whatever. All right, so that was 16, and now by somewhat popular demand, number 17.
Ten four and what?
415. 415? Mm-hmm. Okay,
415.
What's the other number?
4, no, 10 4 is 415. 4 over 50. Right? 4 in the comma thing, the jigger.
Comma.
15 in the parentheses thing, the jigger.
Okay, 4, mm-hmm. comma 15. That's different from 415s. Right? 10 4, 415, so this is like. Make a little more sense in terms of time. You can switch the order of these guys just so that the first time is before the second time. So if this is, let's say it's time still, but this is the height of water, right? You know what I'm talking about? The height of water and then that little computer game we played, okay, where we drew the graph of the water filling that. Or whatever the container was. And this is time, this is also a different height, okay? So at 4 seconds, the height of the water was 15, let's say, inches. So at 4 seconds, the water was 15 inches. And then at 10 seconds, the water was at 4 inches. So what's happening to the water?
It's going down.
It's going down. It's leaving the beaker somehow.
But how did it go down?
How did it go down?
A hole.
Yeah, a hole. Or somebody's drinking it with a straw.
But, can we show that up there on the board?
Show what? Y1,
y2.
It depends on which one you're going to call this one 1?
Yeah.
Because it doesn't matter. You can choose either way you want. So this would be x2, y2. This would be x1, and y1.
Mm-hmm.
So if we want to know how much the height has changed, let's take 4 minus 15. And then we'll take how much time has gone by, 10 minus 4. So how much has the height changed?
Negative 11.
So it's gone down 11 over how long?
6
seconds, right? 11 inches over 6 seconds. And there's no common factor of those two, so it's just a negative 11 over 6. If I were looking at the line, so figuring Russ gets this out, 4:15. And let's call it 15. There's a point at 4:15 and a point at 10:04.
10:04.
Alright. Let's see, it's like about there. So from this point to that point on this line, we'll go down how much?
15. 11.
11 and over how much?
4. 6.
6. Go down 11. Go to the right 6. Negative 11, 6 is the slope, right? And a negative slope means a negative rate, which means we're losing something. Yeah, we're losing money, we're losing height of water, we're losing distance, we're losing weight, we're losing
dogs.
Sure, we can lose dogs.
Lose 11 dogs per
we
losing
lose,
bread and a pound.
The
candy.
Candy. Whatever, yeah. This could literally be a function to describe how much candy we have after Halloween night. It might be linear, it might not. I bet it wouldn't be linear. Alright. That was 17, now number 19. So, it shows this line, a point at 2, 3, and a point at 4, 1. And there's this line going through there. Well, the slope is the vertical change or the horizontal change. What kind of vertical change do we have, positive or negative?
Negative.
We got a negative.
Yeah.
It depends on how we look at it. But if we start here, we go down, we're going to go down. That's negative. What about the horizontal change? What kind of horizontal change is that?
Positive.
If we go, if we were to go from here to there, we'd have a positive y, a negative x change.
So it doesn't matter, does it?
It doesn't matter which way we go.
It could be a negative or a positive, right?
Well, what kind of slope will this be? Are we gaining or are we losing something?
Losing.
We're losing, so we're going to have a negative slope, just like the previous problem.
Wait, what was number 19? What was the problem?
So how much did the vertical change? Well, you can kind of think of it as ending at 1, right, and starting at 3, 1 minus 3. If we call this point number 2 and this point number 1, it would be y2 minus y1 would be 1 minus 3. x2 would be 4 minus x1 would be 2. So we get negative 2 over 2, negative 1. So let's see what they did. They did 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1. Okay, well they did 3 minus 1. So they have it backwards. So they did 3 minus 1. So in the denominator, they should have
2
minus 4. What we have is backwards of what they have. But what they do have is 4 minus. They have 3 minus 1 and 4 minus 2. Maybe because they're a fan of positive numbers. But numbers aren't always positive. It doesn't always happen. So what they should have done is 3 minus 1 over 2 minus 4, or 1 minus 3 over 4 minus 2, but not 1 minus, or not 3 minus 1 over 4 minus 2.
Yeah.
No.
Call 2 over 2.
How come equals 1?
How come?
Never mind.
Look at the outcome. I'm looking.
This would be a positive 1. We should come up with a negative 1 slope.
Yeah.
But it's the same thing.
Positive 1 and negative 1?
Okay. Well, no, because 4 minus 2.
Okay. 4 minus 2 is 2.
Oh,
they
might
get two. They get a positive
they
one.
Switch the other one.
Right. That needs to be in the same order in the numerator and the denominator.
Mm-hmm.
Either x2 minus x1, y2, or y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, or y1 minus y2, x1 minus x2. It needs to be in the same order. Otherwise, you'll get the right numbers, but your slope will be the wrong sign if you don't keep that order consistent.
Sorry, I didn't know.
Alright, so let's say that this is time and this is distance, and then we'll make the distance in feet, and we'll make this time in seconds, and we'll see if it makes any sense. Okay? So this would be like 2 seconds ago, somebody was at negative 3 feet, and then 5 seconds from now, they'll be at 1 foot.
It's like a So
how far did it go? Well, we'll find the difference between the ending y value and the beginning y value. I'm using ending y value and beginning y value kind of like just for convenience sake. There's no beginning and end, right? But for this example, we could think of it as a beginning and an end. Aiden? That would be how much time it got by, or look at how much distance this turtle has traveled. They have traveled, well, they ended at 1, they started at -3. The difference between those two will be how far this thing has gone. Now, how much time it took? Well, since I did 1 minus -3, I should then do 5 minus -2. 1 plus 3 is 4, so this thing has gone 4 feet. 5 plus 2, 7, it's got 4 feet and 7 seconds.
I knew it was, I hate this.
4 feet and 7 seconds. The slope is always the y over the x, not the other way around, y over x.
Y is on top?
Y is in the numerator, yes.
So the y2 has to go first?
If you choose this to be 2 and this to be 1, this is what it would look like.
Appropriate.
Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1.
God.
If you did Y1 minus Y2, let's see what would happen. -3 minus 1, right, over -2 minus 5. Well, that's -3 minus 1 is -4. -2 minus 5 is -7, but a negative divided by a negative is positive. So this is also 4. So, same.
That's
4,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Is it okay if I did something
wrong? Nope. It's always the change in y or the change in x. Okay. If we were to graph this and look at the slope of the equation, it would be y over x.
Well, I was trying to write everything down, but is it okay that if I wrote -4 over -7, since it means the same thing? Or
yeah, sure. I would, you know, in the future, write it as +4/7.
I wasn't sure.
Uh-huh.
So I just went with my first answer, and I was going to turn it into positive, but I wasn't sure if I was supposed to use it.
Well, let's look at these let's look at a point, right, and then if you follow a slope of 4/7, since you have the same slope, -4 over -7. Right, so 4 means I go up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, and the 7 means I go right 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so this is a line of the slope of 4/7. But it's also a line of the slope of -4/-7, because if I started here, I would go down 4, and then that's negative, going down to negative, and then I would go to the left, 7, so they're the same. All right, let's look at the second one. Now we'll just kind of generally, instead of giving the variables names, we'll just say that this is point number 2, and this is point number 1. So I need to take -2 minus 5, y2 minus y1, over 4, that's x2, minus -3, that's x1. -2 minus 5 is -7, 4 minus -3, 4 plus 3. 7, -7 divided by 7?
-1.
So we have a -1 slope.
I got both of them.
Which means that if this were a point on the line, if I went down 1 into the right 1, there's another point. And if I go down 1 into the right 1, there's another point. And it just keeps on going just like that. Yes?
Can we get an effort grade on this?
Yeah.
But what happens if you got both of them wrong?
You get effort on both of them. Molly?
Could we go back to before when we were going over 17?
There it is.
Oh, wait, no, the 19.
Next one after that.
Honestly, the story of a question. So it's kind of random, but did Jaden start over again? Like,
yeah.
Okay.
This
right.
Was, yeah.
I figured it out.
Okay. Cool. Right. So what you need to remember, what I'd really like you to remember is to keep in mind that these variables should kind of, even if you make it up, they should represent something. And a lot of times x represents time, that makes it easy to think about. Y could represent distance, that's pretty common too. It could represent money, it could represent volume of something, it could represent the height of the water, whatever. And the slope is just the change in the y variable, right? The change in the distance in this case, over the change in the x variable, the time in this case, right? And then we get something familiar, feet per second. 4 feet per 7 seconds, 4/7 feet per 1 second. You get a rate of change. The slope is the rate of change. Kyler?
Can you send me fast, please?
Change in y. Alright, we're over there. I'm going to write it again over the change in x. It helps you think of y as distance and x as time. It's kind of a helpful little thing to think of. It's not always going to be that way. Sometimes the variables will be different, but the variables help it to make a little more sense. So when I do something like 1 minus negative 3, I'm finding how far something has traveled, and then I do 5 minus negative 2, I'm finding how long, how many seconds that took. Okay. So, now we're going to talk about, and since we already have our notes out, it's not like we have to take them out, but if you didn't have your notes out, you should probably take your notes out. Let's talk about, I want to talk about lines, so let me get a nice straight line going. Alright, so let's talk about parallel lines real quick. What makes a line parallel to another line?
It's like at the exact same thing and it never touches that line. Like
so those two lines never touch. Are these two lines parallel?
No.
They're not touching?
They will
eventually.
They will eventually because lines go on forever. Okay. Are these lines parallel?
No.
They're going to touch where?
On the back.
Left over there somewhere. So these two have to be exactly the same in some way, right?
Yeah.
There's gotta be something same about them. In fact, if I want these to be parallel, I should really just kind of duplicate this line so we can be sure these two lines will never cross. What is same about these two lines? Daniela?
Their angle is...
Okay.
Angle,
and you're saying slope, right? That's a more mathy word, right? The slope. I heard somebody say the rate of change. Ethan said the rate of change. They have to have the exact same slope, the exact same rate of change, okay? Like if these were the graphs of two cars, what would these two cars be doing that's the same?
Same speed.
Same speed. Same number of miles versus same number of hours. If one of them is going 30 miles an hour, this one's going 30 miles an hour, right? If they were going a different rate, at different slopes,
it would have been
like this, then what's going to happen eventually with this car?
Run into the other car.
Run into the other car if it's, it's directly behind it. It's going faster, right? Its slope is greater, it's steeper. So at some point out here, they'll intersect, which means they will be at the same place at the same time, which is just a mathy word of saying they crashed into each other. Okay. Good. So two parallel lines. Parallel lines. The same. Slope. Is there anything else that's the same about them? Do they cross the y-axis at the same point?
Yeah. One goes through the top. The color, the origin, and one of
the... Okay, two parallel lines are always the same color. I don't know if that's always true.
One goes to the top part, and one goes to the bottom part.
So they cross the y-axis at the same place?
No.
No? So two lines are parallel, just means they have... The only thing that they have in common are...
No,
what?
Rate of change.
The slope, the rate of change. The delta y over the delta x, those are the same. Okay. So... So if one line has a point at negative 3, let's see, negative 3, 2, and another one has a point at, or sorry, this is the same line, negative 4, comma, negative 2. So this is one line, has these two points, okay, and another line has these points at 3, negative 3, and 4, 1. You tell me whether they're parallel or if they aren't. How will you know if they're parallel?
If the slopes are the same.
Slopes are the same, so we should probably find out what?
If the slopes
are the
same. So yeah, what the slopes are and if they're the same. So let's find those slopes, see if they're the same, and if they are, they're parallel. If they're not, they're not parallel. So what do we find out? Are they parallel or are they not parallel?
Parallel.
Okay, let's confirm or deny this. So let's say this is point number, we'll make this 2, why not? We'll make this point number 1. So we'll do 2 minus negative 2 over, so we did 2 minus negative 2, we need to do negative 3 minus negative 4. Let's write this, 2 minus negative 2 is 4, and negative 3 plus 4 is 1, so 4. Question?
Doesn't it matter which way you do it if you switch the 1 for 2 and the 2 for 1?
Nope. As long as, basically, as long as these two guys here are the x and y of the same point, you're fine. And then by default, these would be the x and y of the other one. Okay, we'll do the other one, and if we have to set a slope of 4, they're parallel. So negative 3, right, we'll go negative 3 minus 1. Which means in the denominator we do 3 minus 4. Negative 3 minus 1 is negative 4. 3 minus 4 is negative 1. Negative
same.
9 by negative is positive, positive 4. So yes, they are parallel. Check.
What? Wait.
Yep.
What happens if you got the numbers?
Huh?
How did I get that?
Perpendicular lines. What does perpendicular mean?
Nah,
they're the same.
Cross. If this has a slope of, let's say, 2, let's call that 7. If this has a slope of 2/7, right? That's the slope. The slope of this guy, is it positive or negative, first of all?
Negative.
It's negative. A positive slope line will always have a negative slope line at a perpendicular. Turns out this guy is going to have a slope of, this will be 7, this will be negative 2, so it will be negative 7 over 2. This is a slope of 2/7, this is a slope of negative 7 over 2. That's what we call opposite, because if one's positive, the other's negative, one's negative, the other's positive, opposite reciprocals. Opposite reciprocals. So, 2/7, negative 7/2. If I tell you that there's a line with a slope of 3/4, what's the slope of a perpendicular line? Negative 4? If I tell you that the slope of negative 3/5, then the other slope of a perpendicular line is a positive 5/3. 5/3. Oh, God, hey. Eh? You got a couple of things here for homework. You have what's written.